Guess what, guys? That's right. It is 57 days, and our first clutch of snake eggs is about to get cut. I couldn't be more excited. As a matter of fact, I'm so excited. I've got a brand new razor blade that hopefully I won't cut my finger. Unwrap this. You ready for some cutting? And this was actually the mom right here, which is just a beautiful pastel female. And she was bred to this black pewter cypress, which is a pastel, and it's a black pastel, and it's a cypress ball python. So again, that black pewter cypress will actually be a pastel, a black pastel, and a cypress, and then we got the pastel. So we can produce a super pastel, black pastel, cypress, and all kinds of different combinations there. What do you say we jump into egg number one of the season 2021? Let's go. All right, here we go. Oh my gosh, what is it gonna be? What will the first snake of 2021 be? Woo! Looks right off the bat, it looks like it is definitely a black pewter. Looks like it could potentially be a black pewter cypress too. That black pewter cypress will sometimes have some striping, but also kind of disperses and cleans up the pattern. That is gonna be awesome. So hey, right off the rip, that's our first egg. Egg number two. Here we go. I wanna start getting some of that super pastel stuff in here too. Let's hope for some different things. Woo! Right off the bat, egg number two. I'm glad I didn't cut this one, egg number one, because it's a normal ball python. Again, that's gonna happen, guys. Odds are gonna be up and down this year. We have so many eggs to cut. That was a normal ball python. I'm just happy it wasn't the first egg, because that would have definitely not been the way I wanted to start my year. Let's jump into egg number three. It is so good to be cutting snake eggs again. Woo, doggy. And oh, I see something beautiful in here. Woo, doggy, that's right, baby. We hit the all-gene animal right there. That is actually a super pastel, black pastel, cypress ball python. So it's basically a silver streak cypress ball python. And oh my gosh, take a look at how purple that is. That's what I was going for. You know I love purple snakes, guys. So purple snakes, that was absolutely incredible. All right, we're going to egg number three. We banged it out. We still have one, two, three, four, five more eggs to go. Let's jump into egg number four. Egg number four. Woo, I tell you what, after that egg, I was flipping out. Okay, so what we have here is actually a super pastel. Could be a super pastel cypress because it's super clean and that cypress gene really cleans things up. So we'll see when this hatches out, but it's definitely a super pastel, possibly a super pastel cypress. Whoo, that's good, man. We're starting to heat up now, guys. Egg number five. Here we go, egg number five. More purple snakes, please. Nope, no more purple snakes, but we did get another super pastel. So you can really see the difference. This looks like what is a absolute just super pastel, whereas the other one looks like the super pastel cypress. You can see the cleanliness in those two. Definitely cool. Three more eggs to go. Can we get another purple snake? Let's just get one more. Let's jump in. Here we go. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, we have another black pewter, which appears to be a cypress because that's super cleanliness. So it looks like we have two black pewter cypresses, which isn't bad. Still, we got two eggs left. I want one more purple snake. I know I'm getting greedy, guys, but let's just go ahead and see what we get. Here we go. Come on, two more eggs. We gotta get some cool stuff. All right, up, up. Well, this actually looks like just a normal cypress ball python. So it's not a normal. This at least is a cypress, so that's good. So we only have one normal so far. Last egg, come on, give me something purple. Let's do it. Last egg for the first clutch of 2021. Here we go, I can see it's not purple. And this is just actually a black pastel. Looks like actually a black pastel cypress ball python. So all in all, we got a bunch of cool combinations. Things worked out pretty well. We did hit the all gene animal with that purple snake, which is super cool. So hey, I tell you what, I'm not complaining. First clutch of many clutches that we're gonna be cutting this year. So this is awesome. Egg cutting season is back going. I think our next clutch that we get to cut is 2 or 3 days away. Oh, and by the way, welcome to the vlog, Reptile Army. I hope the start of your day is amazing. You guys know about the movement. That movement is the Reptile Army. That's right. Go ahead to reptilearmy.com and check it out. We hope that we're going to be dropping some new designs in about a week or so, 6 or 8 new designs, but I've got good news. These designs will still be available. Again, 10% of the proceeds go to US Arc, but the entire amount of proceeds go to educating people about reptiles. That means 0% goes in my pocket to buy, you know, Burger King or something like that. The truth is, it's a movement that I'm putting into the reptile community. I want you to become our soldiers. Go to reptilearmy.com. Take a look, and we got some little baby leopard geckos. Ironically enough, these were eggs that were laid this year, but before they bred. So it was basically retained sperm from the year before, but they're really beautiful. It actually happens to be a white and yellow Maxnoe eclipse right here that is basically patternless. And then we have a little Tremper white and yellow Maxnoe. Beautiful, guys. So again, lots of leopard gecko eggs in the incubator, but these are theoretically the first babies of this year that were laid this year. So that's pretty awesome. Actually really excited about this clutch, but let's face it, what clutch am I not excited about? But look at how beautiful this girl is. She's actually a pastel yellow belly. Looks like she's got one egg over here, just hiding out over here. But she's actually bred to a banger male, which happens to be a super stripe spider red stripe. So the super stripe is actually a yellow belly and a specter, and then there's spider, and then there's red stripe in there. breeding into pastel, and then another yellow belly gene. It's gonna be some pretty cool babies. Let's see how many eggs mama has. Looks like a bunch. Mama is not happy. Come on, mama. I know. And look, they've got nice, pretty size eggs, too. Definitely a beautiful female. Gonna have to candle these as well, too, because not only has she kicked the one out, but she's kind of rolling the other ones around. So we're gonna have to, oh gosh, mama's mad. Okay, get, come on. Whoa, whoo. Tell you what, you gotta be careful with this girl for sure. Whoa, she's a fiery little girl. That's for darn sure. She's just protecting her eggs. That's okay, mama. It's all right. We'll get these eggs out of here now. Oh gosh, every time I reach in here, she gets crazy. So what happens is when I clean her up and actually wash her off a little bit, she'll get that egg smell off of her and that maternal instinct will drop a bunch. But regardless, we've got 2, 4, 6 beautiful eggs. Again, a lot of really cool combos. That red stripe and pastel, yellow belly, specter, all that stuff. Who knows what we're gonna get? It's gonna be epic no matter what hatches. Got a quick unboxing to do, which actually has an interesting story behind it. So let's go ahead, roll that unboxing reel. And the other day when I actually unboxed those green tree monitors, which are absolutely beautiful, some of you even noticed. I noticed, but I didn't say anything at the time, that there was something popping out of what was supposed to be the female. Well, I noticed that that's not typically the case. Now, they can have scent glands, but that looked more like hemipenes. But I wanted to actually set them up and then go back and take a closer look at them. And sure enough, they were 2 males. So I wanted a pair, and I ended up with 2 males. I wanted a pair, and I ended up with 2 males. So of course, I reached out to my buddy. He was super cool about it. And basically, we're just shipping one of the males back, and he shipped me another female green tree monitor. Again, monitor lizards aren't the easiest to sex, so it was an honest mistake. You know, it does happen. But again, I didn't want 2 males because 2 males can potentially fight. And even though those had been together for quite some time, and oh my gosh, this is so beautiful. Look at that. Whoa! And although those 2 were living together for some time, oh, now it's peeing on me. And you can basically see these are scent glands on this one, particular one here. And so, no big deal. You can definitely tell the difference between scent glands and hemipenes. There's no doubt about it. So the fact that those were living together, probably the smaller one was probably getting a little bit dominated by the adult male, to be totally honest with you. So we ended up getting a nice, beautiful female to replace it. So we're gonna put this one in with the male and send the other male back. And hey, hopefully they'll get along and they'll have some eggs here in the future. This one is a little bit smaller than the other one, but that's okay because they're gonna grow and do absolutely incredible. So what do you say we go see if we can put this one in and hopefully keep an eye on them and make sure they get along. So again, these guys have a lot of places to hide in here so they can get away from each other and kind of just kind of socialize each other. This one actually is a little bit prettier, I'll be honest with you. And although it kind of jumped away when I first opened, obviously it was probably a little stressed out, it's actually a little bit more calm as well. Look at it, it'll just kind of sit in my hand. So I'm just gonna go ahead and let it go on its own when it decides to. There you go. You can go in there. And again, the male's just a little bit bigger, but not too terribly much. But again, there's hiding spots on this side, there's hiding spots on this side, and the male is actually in this cork bark right now. So there's plenty of places for them to get away from one another. Should be really good. So again, things happen. And that's a good lesson that I've learned, you know, even when you're getting snakes and lizards, always double sex because mistakes happen. I make mistakes, everyone makes mistakes. The last thing you wanna do is raise up a pair of animals, 2 or 3 years later, find out they're 2 males, right? So I'm super happy that that got corrected, and now we have a cool pair of green tree monitors. In the colubrid room, roll that song. That's right, this girl is actually a goinae, or what they would call a blotch king snake, sometimes called Apalachicola County king snakes. Jay always loves that, right, Jay?
I love that.
All right, good. So we'll get this girl all cleaned up. She looks actually really good. Looks like she didn't even lay a clutch of eggs. She's so big. Let's see if she's got some good eggs. Oh yeah, look at that. That's a beautiful clutch of eggs. When I saw her, sometimes when girls actually don't look like they've deflated, you think that they may have laid slugs or something like that, but this girl laid a nice, beautiful, big clutch of eggs. So we'll go ahead and get these guys out of here right quick. This little eggy actually tumbled on us, so we're gonna go ahead and candle that one. We'll count, we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 eggs. That is absolutely amazing. When these babies hatch out, they're really beautiful. They got tons of red on them, absolutely gorgeous. So this is gonna be a beautiful clutch to hatch in a couple months.
This is Bowser, our alligator snapping turtle.
And this is Tabasco.
I'm too short.
Okay, go ahead. I'll help you. Ready?
No, dude, no. Who gave him so many damn tails?
It's got one.
And we're gonna let him swim in Bowser's pond.
Woohoo!
Come on, Tabasco.
Whoa! Whoa! Saw that one.
There you go. There you go. This is his first time swimming.
He's actually doing really good. Like, he's better than my dog.
Let's see if I can let him go and let's see what happens.
Just like in the wild.
Just like in the wild. Look at him. You can tell he's thinking, he's like, what is going on right now? I've never been inside water like this. Here he goes. He's going for a swim. Holy God, what a thumbnail. Going swimming.
You got balls of steel.
And probably chlamydia.
Bye, buddy. You did such a good job.
You did so good. Yeah, I mean, he doesn't even want to leave us.
Hey,
he's still here.
Like,
behind you. Oh, dude, what the?
Oh my God.
Bye, buddy.
This is pretty interesting because this is the egg-eating snake, the Daisy Peltis scabra, and we put this nest up here to put eggs in for it to come eat, and then we thought it's never gonna go up there, so we've been feeding it on the ground. But look at the shed, is actually up in the trees. So it actually climbed up here, obviously climbed all the way around the nest to get itself in a position to get its shed up. So now I think we actually might be able to put an egg in there, and maybe in the nighttime it'll come and actually eat the egg from the nest like we intended it. That's pretty cool. But this is a perfect shed from our egg-eating snake. Pretty excited about this clutch because this is the first clutch of scaleless Texas rats, the scaleless Texas rats that come from our new animals. So these are fresh animals, just kind of the more polymorphic ones that we wanted to hold back that had specific traits that we really like. So the female herself is actually really beautiful, but the males we bred her to are stunning. So I'm excited that we got the first clutch of the year and really the first clutch ever because these are first-time animals and it looks like the clutch is really good. Definitely a bunch of beautiful eggs in here, so definitely gonna have to can these guys because they are definitely loose, and I've said definitely way too many times in this whole thing. So anyways, let's go ahead and get these eggs out of here. All right, right here, and you can see they're kind of all rolling around, so it's definitely I need to candle these, okay? So let's go ahead and get these out and we'll count them up. It does look like we got one little tiny slugger over here. These eggs look like they're actually together, which is good. So we could just set those right down here. These eggs are together, so we can set those down over here. And then all the ones on this side, we'll go ahead and candle. We've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. That means that we definitely have 14 eggs. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, do me a favor. Here is a playlist of egg cutting. You can watch all that you want. Over here, can you please hit that subscription button? Turn your post notifications on. Have an absolutely wonderful day, Reptile Army. Remember, be kind to someone, and I promise I'll see you tomorrow.